मोस्ट ब्यूटीफुल इंचेंटिंग ऑर्नामेंटल फ्लावरिंग ट्री इज द प्राइड ऑफ वर्मा. इट्स ब्यूटी इज सो इंचेंटिंग एंड मैजेस्टिक दैट इट हैज बीन नेम्ड एज क्वीन ऑफ द फ्लावरिंग ट्रीज. द ट्री इज नेटिव टू बर्मा, presently known as Myanmar, and it was the year 1826 when its dried specimen came to the notice of botanist Dr. Wallich. And after that, he carried out a trip to the distant monastery near Marthaban. And there he located the two trees which he named in honor of Lady Sarah Amherst, wife of then Governor General of Burma and India. The botanist Lady Amherst, she has contributed a lot in the botany, in collection of plants, and she always adored the beauty. So one pheasant, gold-crested pheasant, Chrysolophus amhersti, and this flower, Pride of Burma, Amherstia nobilis, stands named to commemorate her contribution. Amherstia, after the botanist and naturalist Lady Amherst, it has the single species, means it is monotypic. Only species is Amherstia nobilis. Presently, it is not available, not seen in the native wild habitat, but it is still available only in the cultivation. Plant is so decorative, so ornamental, it stands introduced in many gardens. Our Sir Jagdish Chandra Bose Botanical Gardens, Calcutta, has the introduction of this tree. Tropical Botanical Garden Research Institute, Palod, Trivandrum, then some universities, Veer Jijaji University, Thrissur Zoo, even in ICFRE, Dehradun, Hyderabad, and Delhi. Tree belongs to Amaltas family, Cicilpiniaceae. Presently, Cicilpiniaceae stands merged within the Fabaceae, Delvergia family. Tree's beauty is seen in the spring foliage when they are purplish red, and the leaflets droop like hanging handsome handkerchiefs. Similar spring foliage beauty is seen in Sitashok, Saraka Isoka. So when the tree Amherstia nobilis is not in flower, it can be mistaken for Saraka Isoka, Sitashok tree. In case of Sitashok, we have the flowers, they are yellowish and they have the four sepals, not petals. And they are born directly from the wood. But in case of Amherstia nobilis, long, hanging, drooping racemes of large flowers add to its charm and beauty. The flowers are scarlet red, but petals are of unequal size. Out of five petals, two are minute, two are of intermediate size with yellow blotch towards the margins, and the fifth petal is largest with a triangular yellow spot, and it grows up to 6-7, even 7.5 centimeter in length and up to 3-4 centimeter in width. And the flowers आर सो ब्यूटिफुल दैट इट हैज बीन नेम्ड एज द ऑर्किड ट्री. मोस्टली ऑर्किड ट्री इज ऑल्सो द बहुनिया वेरीगेटा कचनार, बट दिस पर्टिकुलर प्लांट ऑल्सो हैज एक्सक्विजिट ब्यूटिफुल फ्लावर्स विच लुक लाइक ऑर्किड फ्लावर्स. सो हैंगिंग रसीन ऑल्सो हैज द अनदर डिस्टिंग्विशिंग करेक्टर. इट्स पेडंकल इज अगेन रेड टूवर्ड द डिस्टल एंड. ईच फ्लावर इज सबटेंडेड बाई ब्रैक्स एंड ब्रैक्स आर ऑल्सो ऑफ स्कॉर्लेट रेड कलर. The floral beauty and its red elegance points towards the dawn when we have the sunrise and that kind of color. So tree is also named as Urvashi after the mystical fairy or apsara, heavenly apsara, who was so beautiful and enchanting that the beauty of the Amartya Nobilis stands admired in the same way as our forefathers have admired the beauty of that celestial dancer Urvashi. It is so beautiful, many Hindi names are also available for Amartya Nobilis tree. लाल सारंग, उर्वशी माला, उर्वशी वृक्षम, एज इट बिलोंग्स टू डलवर्जिया फैमिली, अनदर नेम शिंशिपा वृक्षम इज ऑल्सो देयर इन मलयालम लैंग्वेज. कॉमनली दिस फ्लावर इज ऑल्सो नोन एज Noble Amherstia. The beauty of the flower and architecture of the flower resembles Gulmohar, Dahlonyx regia, especially in the fifth largest petal, which is scarlet with a triangular yellow area. Whereas in Gulmohar we have the feathery leaves, its leaves are Sarka Ashoka like. Pinnate leaves. Number of leaflets is even, 6 or 8. It flowers during spring season, March, April. It is a shady tree and remains evergreen except a brief 10, 15, 20 days before new leaves appear. So flowering season is about 2 months in the early summer. The rarity of the tree in the wilderness coupled with failed pollination or fertilization leads to sterile pods. Pods are also red. Simtar like, talwar like, with few seeds, but seeds are not available. So propagation is mainly carried out through ear layering. But this is one of the most popular garden ornamental tree, which has been adored by many botanists and named variously in honor of botanist, naturalist, Lady Amherst. Postal stamp also stand issued to commemorate the beauty of the tree by the Myanmar government, as well as there is also a Cuban stamp of Cuba. Its flowers are visited by many sunbirds, scarlet sunbird, purple sunbird, and even Mrs. Goldie's sunbird. Butterflies are also seen fluttering over the beautiful hanging scarlet red flowering racemes. Tree grows up to 40 feet, roughly 10-12 meter, and it has been planted near the places of worship, especially around the Buddhist monasteries, as the first sighting of the tree by Dr. Wallich was near monastery in Myanmar. It is also seen in the Buddhist monasteries in Sri Lanka and northeastern states. The beauty is unparalleled. Floral architecture resembles the flowers of Tamarindus indica, Imli. Rather, they have been kept in the same subfamily. In case of Tamarindus indica, yellow color is dominant, but they have the pink and red spots lines also. Similarly, in case of Amaryllis nobilis, the predominant color is scarlet red, but yellow spots are also seen. Then five petal flower in both Tamarindus as well as Amaryllis nobilis. Reduction of petals is also seen. Number of stamens is 10. 9 are fused in a bundle and one stamen is free, or sometimes only 9 stamens in a bundle are seen. So either it is monoidelphous or sometimes it is having diadelphous condition. The rarity of the flower and elegance and the way it has been adored in our folklore, literature, mythology, this tree is recommended for introduction in floriculture parks and gardens. It will serve twin purpose. One, it will add charm and beauty to the garden, and second, it will also be a step toward the conservation of the rare taxon, Amaryllis nobilis, which stands wiped out in the wilderness and is very rare, and that way it has gone threatened. So we need to cultivate and propagate the tree in city parks and gardens so that we are able to conserve the species and tell to younger generation what kind of beautiful flowers grow in the Indian and Asian continent.